So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is time for me to review Super Smash Bros. Ultimate for the Nintendo Switch, obviously. My most anticipated game is finally here. I remember back in March when Nintendo announced this at their Nintendo Direct livestream. I was so excited, but I was a little disappointed to see that release date. I was like all the way in December though, but man oh man, December came quick, I could say that again. But anyway, today, it's time to review some Smash. I played, I sat down with it a couple of hours all night, and it is time. It is time. Now, I'm going to talk about the cons first. I'm not really a video game reviewer like that. I just say how it is. You know, there's no script or nothing like that. If there's something wrong with it, I'm going to say how it is. If there's something right with it, I'm going to say how it is. Simple as that. But anyway, right when I played my first game of Smash, I was disappointed to see that there is no D-pad support, so you can only use the analog stick. And if you play a lot of fighting games, you guys know the D-pad is the way to go. I play a bunch of games like Mortal Kombat, Tekken, Street Fighter, you name it, I play it. The D-pad is the way to go, and especially if it's a 2D game, any 2D games, it really just belongs on the directional pad, hands down. Three-dimensional games, that's the analog stick. So seeing Smash exclusively or only on the analog stick, that's kind of disappointing in my opinion. Now obviously I've gotten used to it, and I gotta say it is pretty accurate using the analog stick too as well to be an analog stick. But still, you know, if you play a lot of fighting games, you're gonna be kind of disappointed to see that, or to feel that I should say, or have that as the controls. And the sad thing is, you can't change it. Now, there's something in the game where you can change up some of the buttons. You can change everything but that. You can't change the movement. So hopefully Nintendo can push out an update, have it both the analog stick and the D-pad. Because, you know, everybody have different, you know, different strokes for different folks. That's what they say. You know, just have it for both, the analog stick and the D-pad. Now, as for the taunts, have it where you can hold one of the shoulder buttons and then press one of the D-pads to perform that taunt. So they can push an update to fix that. The next con, and trust me, there's not that many cons with this game, just a spoiler out there. 1v1 matches. I was playing local play with my brother, right? I just feel like your character should always face your opponent at all times. I know it's like that for Ken, but I feel like it should be like that for all characters. I feel like there's a lot of times where with like me and my brother, we fighting, but we facing on the opposite side. So we like fight in the air basically. Because, you know, Smash moves so quick, and we coming from Brawl, so this is like a day and night difference. The speed is, you know, it's faster, you know, it looks more stylish, vivid. It's just a totally different feeling, and we coming from the Wii Remote. You know, that's probably my biggest confession right there. You guys probably didn't know, I used the Wii Remote to play Super Smash Bros. Brawl. So I didn't use the GameCube or the classic controller. The Wii Remote was our cup of tea, basically. So coming from the Wii Remote to a Pro Controller, you know, we got to get used to that. And especially this is a new console, everything is new. So yeah, I got to get used to everything. All in all, we should always be facing each other while we're doing 1v1s. Four battles, you know, have it anywhere, because, you know, four battles is a little bit more chaotic than 1v1s. But 1v1s is for the serious stuff, you know. No items, no smash balls, just straight smashing. Pause. This stuff can be fixed within the update. Now, the next con, this is very, very, you know, this is nitpicking. I feel like the stage selection screen, I feel like they should have two pages. I feel like it's a little bit hard to see, especially if you have like a small, maybe a 20-inch TV or maybe 32-inch. It might be hard for you guys to see, so I feel like they should have made the thumbnails a little bit more bigger and have like different pages of stages. And yes, you can see the stages on the left, but that's just me being a nitpicker. So now some more cons. These stuff don't really bother me too much. No home run contest, no target practice. What else is missing? No coin battle. You know, some features are missing, but hey, I would rather give up some features and have more characters and stages than have those modes. Because I'm going to be honest, I don't think that many people played Break the Targets or even Home Run Contest. You know, that's something that you play one time and that's it. So yeah, in exchange for more stages, 108 stages and 74 characters, that's a win. I'd rather that. And really the last con, but I'm just saying this just to be funny. No Waluigi. I mean, come on. Waluigi is probably the only character that's missing right now, I feel like. I mean, we have Peach, we even have Daisy. Daisy is the same thing as Peach, and we still didn't get Waluigi. Come on. Sakurai, add him in the game, for real. That's the con. That's the last con. Now, on to the pros. That's a lot of pros, so I'm going to keep this list nice and short and simple. I don't want to make this video 30 minutes long, and I don't want to waste your guys' time. But the pros, this is probably easily one of the best-looking Nintendo Switch games yet. Now, Breath of the Wild is right there, I would say. Breath of the Wild looks beautiful. Splatoon 2 is beautiful, but something about Smash, it's just so stylish and so colorful. It looks fun. It looks fun to watch. I mean, watching back this gameplay is like, whoa, I want to play right now. So, you know, graphics and the colors, that stuff means a lot, obviously. The sound, the music, it's a bunch of, I think there's like over, how many songs? It's like over 1,000 songs, something wild. And props to Sakurai for squeezing as much content here, man. 74 characters, 108 stages, a bunch of music, bunch of songs. We are missing the masterpieces. I forgot to mention that in the cons. But that was, I didn't include that because those are like trials. You only play for a minute. By the time you turn around, the trial is done. So that was kind of like a waste of time. The animations has been redone. So this is definitely a brand new Smash game. This is not a port. Some people still saying it's a port. But they really did redone the animations, refined it, made it a little bit more smoother. And really talking about the characters, every character is unique. Some of them, they play extremely different. Like Ryu, you're kind of like you're playing Street Fighter, but you're not playing Street Fighter. Mega Man plays like Mega Man. So it's just like they play just like in their games. And really, going back to the stages again, I'm sorry for keep on going back to this. It's kind of like doubling or maybe even tripling that 108 number, because you have the Battlefield ones, like the Battlefield style stages. So it's going to take out all the BS on the map, and it's going to make it a single platform with a couple of platforms. And then you have the Omega stages where it just makes it one long platform. So that's definitely a nice touch. So you can literally play on any map without worrying about, oh, it's this map again. Once you toggle on that Battlefield Omega, you have nothing to worry about. Now, when you first start up Smash, you're going to be very, very limited with characters. So you're obviously going to need to unlock them. And having that challenger approaching screen, it's just like, it makes you happy every time. It's like, yes, a new character, new character, new character. And then by the time you turn around, the roster is so humongous. Unlocking characters, it takes some time. I made a video on how to unlock the characters even faster. So make sure you guys check out that video if you have Smash. Maybe you want to unlock the characters. But it's fun. It's fun actually unlocking the characters, but it's kind of tedious after a while because maybe you have your favorite character, but he's locked. So, and maybe it's the last person or it's so far. It's like, for example, Wolf. If I want to play with Wolf, I can't do that. I have to keep on playing with Falco or somebody like that. So, you know, so after a while it gets tiresome, but I like it though. I like how they started off the roster with Nintendo 64 characters first, and then you just progress like that. And besides, everybody in Smash is in this game. That's another pro right there. So you really don't have no excuse like, oh man, I don't have Mewtwo. Mewtwo is in the game. Everybody is in this game. And that also leads me, the DLC characters, they're definitely going to be someone totally new. So there's no like returning character because everybody's here already. And that's the model of the game. Everyone's here. And really, just last night, or the VGA Awards night, they just announced the Persona 5 character, Joker. So, I don't really pay attention too much with the Persona series, but, it's just, you're gonna see new characters every time now. But it's just a bunch of pros. I haven't played World of Light yet. I want to sit down and actually pay attention to that, because right now I just want to play quick games of Smash, because I'm finishing up college and stuff like that. I want to be able to just sit down, play World of Light all day, nothing to worry about with life, and I just want to play my eyes out. So yeah, I just want to play with no worries, and maybe when the semester is over for me, I'll play that all day if I have to. But yeah, I didn't even mean to make this video 10 minutes, so those of you guys in the comments, oh, 10 minute mark, I didn't mean to. I'm just saying how it is, man. I'm just being myself, and that's it. But hey, anyway, that's pretty much it for my review of Smash Ultimate. Definitely, this is a staple game. If you have a Switch, this is literally a no-brainer. I'm going to give this a 10 out of 10, a 5 out of 5. And those two cons that I mentioned earlier, maybe it's just me. Melee players are used to playing with the analog stick, but haven't played Melee in such a long time. I can't remember if it was the analog stick or the D-pad, and I was young as hell too, so I can't really remember. But maybe it's just me, I gotta get used to it. Maybe it's better to play on the analog stick than the D-pad, who knows. And then really, your character not facing towards you on 1v1s, I feel like Nintendo should add that in. With all those cons aside, it's still a 10 out of 10. You know, it's a bunch of, it's like 50 million pros with this game. I mean, I'm being over dramatic, but it's a lot of, it's more pros than cons. And those pros really outweighs the cons, basically. Thank you guys so much for watching. That's my review of Smash Ultimate. Make sure you guys subscribe to see more gaming content and other videos. And make sure you guys drop a like on this video. Help me out tremendously. Comment down below. Your feedback is always appreciated. And make sure you guys follow me on Twitter at SimplyPops. The online of Smash Bros. Ultimate, or Smash Ultimate, I don't know why I just said the whole thing. It's coming soon. I'm going to renew my online service and we're going to chill out and we're going to spend some time together. I'm going to live stream. We're going to have a good time. And that's about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Later.